Though the tears may fall, my song will rise to you. Though my heart may fail, my song will rise to you. While there's breath in my lungs, I will praise you, Lord. In the dead of night, I'll lift my eyes to you. Though the waters rise, I'll lift my eyes to you. While there's hope in this heart, I will praise you.
Well, good morning. Welcome to Scarborough and to our worship again. We join you here on a slightly windy day from Peacehome Park in the North Bay. As we continue worship this morning, we thank Rent Collective, who started our meeting with a song entitled "The Joy of the Lord is Our Strength." Joy, of course, is a key element in the kingdom of God and in our kingdom living. And so as we continue this morning, we're going to encounter a further song entitled "We Seek Your Kingdom." "We Seek Your Kingdom" is a whole life worship song to a tune that we know so well entitled "Abide With Me." It's a song written by Noel Robinson, by Andy Flanagan and Graham Hunter. And it's one that inspires us to look at our daily living, our daily tasks through God's eyes, and to live out the prayer, "Your kingdom come." And so we hope you will enjoy singing this new song together.
Just now, we invite Paul and Lindsay Barker to come and lead us in a time of prayer.
We want to pause just now in our homes, offices, or cars, wherever we are. Now, it might be Saturday night, or Sunday morning, or Wednesday afternoon. Whatever the location or the hour, we pause and invite your Holy Spirit to come. Loving Father, we call out to you in prayer today, absolutely confident you will answer and that you are there. Your word tells us so.
Thank you for today, Father. Thank you for providing for us and making sure that we have everything that we need. You are so good to us. Father God, we long to be like Jesus, so that with one mind and one voice, we can glorify you. We pray that our hearts would overflow with thankfulness. We pray that we would continue to rejoice always, praising you, Lord. May our hearts be filled with joy.
Father, help us to accept one another with all our many differences, just as Jesus accepts us. Holy Spirit, defend us. Fight against the enemy and his evil ways. Help us not to be disheartened or full of anxiety. We pray for peace and we pray for your joy to complete us.
We pray that we would be content and thankful. Transform us, Lord, and let our joy be evident. Strengthen us for your work and make us effective witnesses to your amazing love and incredible power. We praise you, Lord God, for you are the giver of all good gifts. Father, we admit that it can sometimes feel hard to be joyful in the middle of a busy day, at a difficult or painful time, but when the cares of our hearts are many, we cannot close our hearts to you.
Thank you, Father, that we have your promise to never leave us again. We are able to trace the rainbow through the rain. Your comfort and presence gives us renewed hope and joy.
Today, we choose to take refuge in you and rejoice. We will sing for joy because you are our strength and salvation. You are the God of all hope. We ask you to fill us with your joy this day. Today, we choose to worship you. Amen.
want to say thank you to Lindsay and Paul for that lovely time of reflection this morning. And to conclude this time, we invite Jerry Penrose to come and lead us in a wonderful song of worship, which is simply entitled, Thank You, Jesus, for the Blood.
Was a wretch, I remember who I was. I was lost, I was blind, I was running out of time. Sin separated, the breach was far too wide. But from the far side of the chasm, you held me. So you made a way across a great divide. Left behind heaven's throne to build it here inside. And there at the cross you paid the debt I owed. Broke my chains, freed my soul for the first time I had.
Just now, we invite you to join with us as we read scripture together. So if you'd like to get your Bibles out, your app on your phone, whatever you're using this morning, and join with us as we turn to Romans chapter 15, verses 1 to 13.
But we who are strong ought to bear with the failings of the weak, and not just please ourselves. Let each of us please his neighbor for his good, to build him up. For even Christ did not please himself, but just as it is written, the insults of those who insult you have fallen on me. For everything that was written in former times was written for our instruction, so that through endurance and through encouragement of the scriptures we may have hope. Now may the God of endurance and comfort give you unity with one another in accordance with Christ Jesus, so that together you may with one voice glorify the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Receive one another then, just as Christ also received you to God's glory. For I tell you that Christ has become a servant of the circumcised on behalf of God's truth to confirm the promises made to the fathers. And thus the Gentiles glorify God for this mercy. As it is written, because of this I will confess you among the Gentiles, and I will sing praises to your name. And again it says, rejoice, O Gentiles, with his people. And again, praise the Lord, all you Gentiles, and let all the peoples praise him. And again, Isaiah says, the root of Jesse will come, and the one who rises will rule over the Gentiles, and in him will the Gentiles hope. Now may the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you believe in him, so that you may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit.
Just now, we want to invite you to give in our offering as we give to the Lord. As we give, we're going to watch a video clip, which is a very contemporary way of presenting scripture. And the scripture this morning comes from the book of James.
Consider it your joy, my brothers, whenever you face trials of many kinds. Consider it pure joy, my brothers, whenever you face trials of many kinds. Because you know, you know, you know, you know, that the testing of your faith develops perseverance. Because you know, you know, you know, you know, that the testing
verses 2 and 3.
We all have times when things are hard.
The road to hell is very far.
That's when it's time to trust the Lord.
That's when we see our Savior's heart.
We count the joy when there's a test.
Yes, the joy, cause God's in it.
He uses trials to show us how.
He'll never let us down.
Consider it your joy, my brothers, whenever you face trials of many kinds. Consider it pure joy, whenever you face trials of many kinds. Because you know, you know, you know, you know, that the testing of your faith develops
We do want to say a huge thank you for your giving this morning and for your continued generosity as we continue to build God's kingdom here in Scarborough. Just now, we're going to sing together with Liverpool Walton Songsters a wonderful song which says, "I sing because I'm happy."
Over the past week, we have started to consider what it would look like if we were to encounter the fullness of the kingdom of God in our lives. Last week, Angela spoke of salvation, freedom, justice, and of course the impact of peace in our lives. Well, this week we want to continue to consider some of the hallmarks of the kingdom and the facets and the evidence in particularly of joy in our lives. Well, I'm not sure what constitutes joy in your life. No doubt there will be many things depending on your own personality and your makeup. Recently, Angela and I had two real encounters and experiences with joy, both with our daughter and husband, Charlotte and Alex. She recently visited and stayed in a caravan just outside Scarborough. And on one evening, we all travelled together to Ravenscar. As we travelled there at 10 o'clock in the night, it was pitch black, and we simply laid down in a field in the blackness and stared at the incredible starry skies as we took in the Creator's galaxy. What a sense of joy that brought to us. The second was over this past week. As a teacher, Charlotte had taken some chickens' eggs into school with an incubator, and she showed some footage of the eggs hatching and these beautiful new chicks. What, again, an incredible encounter of joy. But I am very conscious that these are momentary pieces of joy. They're passing. They're interludes of happiness. You know, over the past week, I've been blown away by Isaiah 58, because in here we discover a sense of eternal joy, joy in the kingdom. You know, this chapter is one we could spend a month unpacking, but I want to share just a few thoughts this morning as we unpack this chapter. You see, years later, after Isaiah has written this chapter, still there are nuggets of gold we can encounter which will help us in our journey of joy. You know, I have to confess, there are times I get very frustrated with God. Why on earth is he, why isn't he conforming to my plan? After all, surely Jesus did say, if you ask anything in my name, I'll do it. Or did he? Well, I have to confess, I get frustrated. And I think the Hebrew people also encountered that frustration. You see, if we follow Isaiah 58, God observes his people. He says this. He says, they seek me out. They try to know my ways. They ask me for just decisions. And they're genuine in wanting me to show up. But they're frustrated. They're doing all the religious stuff. And they think I don't notice. And so it is then that God expresses a bit of a problem. And that problem is very much around religious observance. You see, God says, for years, they've been brought up with the belief that as long as they do the right things, then I'll do my magic. And here's a great example. The practice of fasting had been a central one and a means of drawing close to God. But it became a bit of an image thing. If they put on the right clothing, took up the right props, the sackcloth, the ashes, if they took a bow a day to bow their head, if they prayed, if they went even without food for the day, then they've done their bit. Back to work, back to reality. But here's the issue. The point they missed was that fasting was never meant to be a religious observance. It was never meant to be a religious duty. Fasting is meant to be a lifestyle, not a one-day event. And you see, clearly God was watching and he calls his people out on their behavior and his attitude, on their attitudes. He says this, yes, you fast, I see it. Yes, you fast, but at the end of the day, you still go home and then you exploit your workers. Yes, you fast, but at the end of the day, you go home and you fall out in lumps with each other. Yes, you fast, but then you go home and you get fists out and you fight with each other. You know what? You can't go on like this, because the lifestyle that I seek for you incorporates a daily practice of living out kingdom values and behavior. And it looks a bit like this. See verse 6, it's a life breaking the chains of justice. Again in verse 6, it's a life freeing men and women from the weight of oppression. It's a life feeding the hungry, helping the homeless, clothing the poor, verse 7. And get this, it's even a life of caring for your own family. How often do we neglect our own families in the pursuit of success and even in religious observance? And you know what? We find in verse 13, you need also to rest on the Sabbath. Well, I think there are a few things there that could perhaps daunt us and scare us. That is until you look at the payback. Just consider these hallmarks of kingdom living. You see, when kingdom living comes to your life, so does joy. And look at the elements of joy that Isaiah identifies. Verse 8, your light will break like the dawn. Your healing will occur. You'll encounter righteousness. You'll encounter the glory of God. You'll respond and you will know his presence. You'll know God's guidance in your life. Verse 11, God will strengthen you. Your life will be like a well-watered garden. Your life will be like a spring of water which never fails to flow. Your life will be one of triumph. Get this, and you will find joy in the Lord. And further to that, there's also a payback for your community. For God promises when you encounter all of that, you will also have the joy of seeing ancient ruins rebuilt, the reconstruction of your streets and dwellings. Well, how can you be sure of that? Because God says so. God promises it. Look at verse 14. And so today we look forward. It's with the challenge. It's a challenge that we change from a religious movement observing religious practice to a movement and individual who observe kingdom living. Is a passage for the activist? No. It's a passage for each and every one of us to encounter the blessings of God through the everlasting joy of kingdom living. Perhaps like me, you need help and encouragement with that journey of growth. And so I do invite you today to connect with our church fellowship as we discover all that God has in store for us. You're not alone. We walk this journey together, and we stand before God who has promised you and I everlasting joy. So let's walk into that experience. Let's learn how to live as Jesus showed us. Let's enjoy within our community who are desperate for joy, the blessings of God our Father in kingdom living.
Just now, we want to say a huge thank you to Steve for sharing God's word with us this morning and encouraging us on our journey of kingdom living. And I really hope that this week you will notice not just moments of joy, but you will learn to live every day under the joy of the Lord. So what else could we conclude our worship with this morning than singing together this wonderful song of praise, Joyful, Joyful, We Adore Thee.
thank you for joining with us today. We hope that you have found blessing as well as challenge through God's word and through our worship. We leave a benediction with you this morning that says, may Christ dwell in your hearts through faith, that you, being rooted and grounded in love, may have the strength to comprehend with all the saints what is the breadth and the length and the height and the depth, and to know the love of Christ that surpasses all knowledge, that you may be filled with all the fullness of God. We pray that today you will be filled with the joy of the kingdom. Go into this week and be blessed as you go out and sharing the love of Christ with our community. Well, as we conclude this morning, we're going to send you out with a smile on your face. We're going to send you out with your feet tapping as the Canadian staff band play a piece of music called Shine. And to that, we have a group of international timbrelists to do their stuff for us this morning and send us out with a smile on our face. God bless you this week.